Ladies and gentlemen, a short presentation where we will be starting with where we are and how we are going to go ahead. It's a small movie which we are going to present in front of you. So there are heroes in those movies which we'll be introducing in the later stage. So we'll start with the yesteryears, how the movies used to be. We'll start with the flashback. So what has happened till now in the e-commerce industry? We'll start with that. So the movie of e-commerce started in 2002 with Bazi.com, Rediff.com, India Plaza, and everyone. But it actually started flourishing from 2009. In 2009 to 2014, we have seen the internet buyers, online buyers, have grown from 5 crores to 15 crores. The smartphone users have grown from 3 crores to 12 crores. And a great, great leap in the online revenue, which is from 1,800 crores in 2009 to 18,000 crores in 2014. So it's a great jump. Unfortunately, in this entire journey of growth, the offline retailers have not contributed much. And that's really sad. So all the companies which we had done well have started after 2007, and they have done really good. Even though the offline retailers have all the strengths of brand, supply chain, consumers, distribution, retail points, all things were there, but they were not able to understand where the consumer is moving. And that's the reason they were lagging behind adopting the digital channel for commerce perspective. Whereas the pure play online guys came there, understood the consumers, started something from the scratch. They built the entire thing from the scratch, and they executed very well, and they have taken the most of the pie of the revenue which was there. So is it lost for online retailers? We don't think so. So still, there is a lot of scope for online retailers to come back on the bus, be at the party, and make merry out of it. So what we are going to do is to first try to understand where the online retailers are missing. So the consumers have moved very fast, and they are moving to various channels. So they are accessing the information through smartphones. They are accessing information on web stores. They are taking the feedback from their friends through Facebook. They are liking it on Facebook. They are sharing it on Facebook, Twitter, everything. They are visiting comparison shopping sites. They are checking various offers there. And then they are making a very informed decision where to buy from. And they are buying from the channel where they are most comfortable are. So they are buying through smartphones, they are buying through web stores, they are calling the call centers, they are using the in-store applications, they are using the mobile applications. So wherever they are comfortable, they are buying from that particular channel. So offline retailers need to make sure that they are present across all the touch points which are there. So somebody is going on the mobile app, downloading the mobile app, offline retailers should have a mobile app. They need to have a mobile site. Of course, they need to have a website. They might need to have a presence where the maximum traffic currently is generated, which are marketplaces. So they need to be there everywhere where the customer is. They need to have a Facebook store. They need to have a Twitter handle. They need to have a YouTube channel, everywhere. So I can keep on going how they should be embracing the digital channels to make sure they are in front of the consumers whenever consumer is looking for their product or the brand. So now what I wanted to do is I want to introduce few of the heroes of this movie which have played to their strength and used digital channel effectively. So the first hero of my story is Godrej Nature's Basket. What they have done is they have married the content and the commerce beautifully. If you have seen it, if you can look at the screen, what they have done is that they have created various recipes for various cuisines. So anybody who is interested in, say, a recipe, for example, somebody is interested in a pasta. So they go on the site, they look at all the recipe which is there to how to make a pasta. And when they are reading that, what happens is the products related to that recipe is subtly pushed to them. So you are consuming the content, and subtly they are pushing the product to you, where you are making a choice of buying that product very easily. So they have married this very nicely and they are doing extremely well in this. So every time they don't have to actually go and give the discounts or anything, because the content what they are promoting, they are putting it on the site, is encouraging, it's refreshing. So every time who is interested in cooking, who is interested in various cuisine, want to understand about new cuisines, goes on the site without actually they giving a discount on the product. So they have effectively countered the discounting. So most of the retailers whom we met, they actually talk about that, how we can let's say for the predatory pricing which the marketplaces are offering, how we can combat that. So there are ways to combating them. No, not necessarily you need to give the discounts, you need to offer freebies or anything. If you know your strengths, if you know your consumer, yes, you can use digital in the best and effective way. What they have also done is they have actually mapped the delivery locations to stores what they have and the stock what they have in that store, because they are dealing in the perishables, they are dealing in the products which are maybe high in shipping. So somebody is buying a product of say $200 will not be interested paying 100 rupee shipping charges. So what they have done is that they have made sure that whatever somebody is coming to from Mumbai, so he will see only the stock which is available across the stores in Mumbai. So which makes sure that there is no stock options or non-deliverable pin codes or these kind of a bad user experience is not there for the consumer. My second hero is one of the biggest wholesalers who are using this digital technology, a digital platform for a B2B. So what they are doing is that they have a large number of sales team. So what they are doing is that they are empowered the sales team. The sales team is going to the retailers, taking the orders on behalf of retailers, punching it. So by the time the salesperson comes back to the wholesale depot, the orders are already in process. So what they have done is they have reduced the time, the turnaround time for through which they can effectively and efficiently can deliver the goods extremely fast to the retailers. My third hero is Adishwar Electronics, who is a renowned retailer who has more than 60 odd showrooms in southern India. What they have done is what they have used the